Hi, hello friends, welcome to World Explorer India. Today we are going to discuss about conflicts and conflict resolution. In our day-to-day life, we do face conflicts in our families and also in organizations where we work. Effective conflict resolution will give to productive life or productive work. Conflict arises when we are having different needs and different goals, but we have to choose only one best action. Based on this conflict resolution, our behavior is going to develop. Any damage to achieve the goals which cause pleasure to us will lead to anxiety, and ultimately it can lead to mental illness also. To understand the conflict resolution, we need to understand basic structure of id, ego and superego. Id works on the pleasure principle, ego is balancing between the id and superego, and superego is working on the perfectionist principle. So ego is balancing between id and superego. If there is any damage causing to ego, it will lead to malfunctioning. To know more about defense mechanisms, do check out the video of ego defense mechanisms in my YouTube channel. There are different types of conflicts, that is approach conflict, approach avoidance conflict, avoidance conflict, multiple approach avoidance conflict. Where is the problem? Is it because of the process, or we have to identify in the process where is the loophole and we have to bring the positive solutions to go for conflict resolution. So in our organization, if any problem is arising because of miscommunication or because of lack of resources, there may be a conflict which will happen between employers or between employee and customer. So in such cases, we have to identify where exactly the problem is. That is what we can say is root cause analysis. So how we can do this is, what happened, where happened, when happened, how happened, and why it happened. That is 5 W's. 5 W means what, where, when, how, and why. If you are well versed with this 5 W's, you are able to identify exactly what is the conflict, and it will also help us to have a better understanding about the conflict. And even we can identify the possible solutions with the group discussions or with the help of insights with the previous problem resolutions, etc. So if there is any damage which is occurring to ego, then we should have proper defense mechanisms. Some of the defense mechanisms I have discussed in my previous video in this YouTube channel. You may go through the link which I have displayed here, or you can search defense mechanisms World Explorer India and you can directly get the video of defense mechanisms. Defense mechanisms usually function to protect the ego from the threats which will cause damage to the ego. That is, our self-identity is based on how strong our ego is. And apart from this, we have to know some of the additional techniques such as catharsis or emotional ventilation. Catharsis means we have to able to express the feelings or actions which can cause damage to us or which can bring positive solutions to us. All these things we can discuss in front of some trusted person. And next thing is communication. Means example, let us see here customer care. If there is a problem between a buyer and seller, we can talk to a customer care to resolve our issue. Next thing is relationship issues. Relationship issues are very common between husband and wife or between a boss and employee. So the thing is, any relation needs time. So you should be able to give time to the relatives. And next thing is, if there is a conflict, it is causing stress and it will ultimately cause anxiety. So we have to identify the causative of stress and remove the stress causative, and so that there will be a chance of good relationship. And also try role reversal. Role reversal means we are going to exchange the roles and we see what is the best possible solution. So even in organizations, if there is conflicts between individuals, it can lead to organizational performance. It can affect the organization productivity. So organization should have some of the policies how they are going to resolve the conflicts between the individuals and how can they can build a stronger teams and also good impact of organization among the customers. Obviously, if there is a conflict, then there will be decreased communication and ultimately it will affect the performance. Let us take an example of eating. Why do we eat? Eating is basic need because every human organism will have hungry. But too slim or too fat, these are the images which are being projected by the media and the actors or actresses which are giving challenges to us in our daily life. And based on this media advertisements, are we choosing how much to eat and what to eat and what not to eat? Power versus independence. Everyone wants the power and also the independence. Which one do you choose? Do you choose power or do you choose independence? It all depends on your mindset. If power is more satisfying, you will choose the power. But if you want to avoid the nuisance which will you get because of the power, you may choose independence. Even such conflicts can be resolved only with the knowledge about the power or independence. Parents and children. There is a conflict when there is very strict actions being imposed or strict regulations being imposed on the children. But if you are able to be warm and you set the rules and also discuss the enforcement, how you are going to give punishments or how you are going to affect your relationship. If you are able to educate the children and also you are warm and comfort giving to your child, you will not face any such issues. But if you are very authoritative and very rigid, your children may have conflict with you. And toilet training. Whenever a small child is being given toilet training, they also face such conflicts, like there is a demand from the parents and also they want to attain independence or autonomy. So during toilet training also, they need positive reinforcement, and you should be able to explain them what is good and what is bad. So here it is the basic foundation where children is going to develop their behavior. There is also positive side of the conflicts, because conflicts will give creative solutions to us, and also it will help in collaboration, problem solving, and also the shared understanding also. Means it will help us in self-identification. Means suppose there is a conflict between two persons and you have to choose only one. Means approach and avoidance. Means the person who has best solution we are going to approach. Ultimately the other person will identify they are not so worthy. Next is positive side of conflict is collaboration. Collaboration is now the person who feel inferior, they have to collaborate with the superior idea person. And also it will help in problem solving, because we are giving them a teamwork. They have to brainstorm and they are going to bring the positive solutions by which we can move forward. If conflicts are not resolved, as we have already discussed, conflicts can lead to mental illness. Some of the examples here are conflicting messages lead to schizophrenia. Schizophrenia is most common mental illness, and apart from this, it can even lead to suspicion, that is called as paranoid. Anxiety and depression. Depression is very common if it is a relationship conflict. If there is a relationship conflict, we can see depression. And if there is conflict, again it may even lead to OCD and PTSD. OCD is obsessive compulsive disorder and PTSD is post traumatic stress disorder. In obsessive compulsive disorder, we might be seeing the actions such as repeated actions, like they may be combing continuously, they are seeing the mirror, and sometimes they are going to check the whether they have been house has been locked or not, or etc. PTSD is if they are having some of the conflicts which they cannot forget, which has caused lot of damage to their ego, they are going to have the recall of memories, that is called as flashbacks. Flashbacks is very common in PTSD. Some other conflicts which we see in daily life is independence versus dependence, intimacy versus isolation, cooperation versus competition. We want to achieve independence by we should be able to get our own job and we should not be dependent on someone else. But during the changes of transition phases, we should be able to gain independence, but we also got dependent with the family members. So we have to choose it. Who will face the more conflicts? Is it the men or the women? Men and women both do face the conflicts, but women are more facing conflicts than men. Because let's say an example of marriage, they have to choose between the career and marriage. So they know there are multiple benefits if they are getting married and they are having losing one of the job or which may be career. So they may choose between both of it. They will approach, they will have a conflict resolution mechanism here, that is multiple approach and avoidance. So final solution to conflict is whether the conflict is small or big, we should go for a constructive solution but not the destructive solutions. And there are dreams which is suggesting us that we are facing some of the conflicts, but it's not right always. But dreams do help. We can identify the dreams, we can keep a diary beside us when we are going to sleep, and when we wake up we can write the dreams so that we can identify what is the coherence between the dream. And dream analysis do help in identifying the conflicts which is intra-psychic. And next thing is insomnia. Insomnia is sleeplessness. If there is sleeplessness, it will lead to stress, and again it can lead to miscommunication which will cause conflict among the friends or family members. So have a good sleep, at least 8 hours per day, and you can even find about a video about sleep and sleep disorders in my YouTube channel, you can search. And whenever you are having a good mental health, whenever you are having a good problem solving capacities, you can face conflicts in a stronger manner. If you have any queries related to conflicts, do post as a comment, and do subscribe, share, and if you want any more information or you may suggest topics on which I can make further videos, do comment in the comment section. And do check out the videos related to mental health in my YouTube channel. Thank you so much.